Welcome back to Reading Bear. Today, we'll take a look at some new MID a-hole stories. And if you enjoyed my content, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and post some bear emojis in the comments. Let's go!
First one posted by user Ain't No Home. Titled, Aita for buying a house with a different real estate agent instead of my sister. I'm 37 male and still living with my parents. Before you grab the torches and pitchforks, I did it to save money, pay off all my debt, tuition was a witch, and saved enough and invested enough to afford a house with the help of a small mortgage, haven't bought it yet, just made sure my finances were in order first. I'm single, I have a full-time job, healthcare, so I'm still working despite things, and I never had a relationship, aka I'm a virgin. I'm a total geek who loves to play video games when I'm not working, watching TV, and anime. My sister recently became a real estate agent and I sought her out to help me find a place to buy and move into. During our conversations about condos or bungalows, she would remark about how I'm making our parents worry about not having a girlfriend, or that I shouldn't try to make money so hard if I'm going to just retire and spend all day in my room playing video games or watching anime. I keep telling her that it's none of her business, going so far as to say I don't appreciate her condescension. I asked her if she treats her clients this way and her response was, most of my clients aren't so stubborn and have a lifestyle fairly close to most people so they understand what I'm talking about. She told me our mother asked her to introduce some of her friends to me and quipped, I wouldn't do that to my friends. Clearly, she thinks I'm a loser, and I got sick of it. I told her I'm no longer looking to buy property, and I stopped talking to her. Instead, I found another real estate agent, one who behaves professionally, and I learned not to mix family and business together. My parents found out about this, and they're upset that I'm doing business with an outsider instead of family. My sister found out and her condescension has gotten worse. I don't want to block her, because that would be the end of family ties from my perspective, but I also hate her insults. To be fair, from society's standard viewpoint, I got a good education, a good job, no debt, I don't drink, smoke, and I obey the law. However, I spend most of my free time playing video games, watching anime, and I plan on never being married. So essentially, from my family and society's standpoint, I am a loser. It's this nagging feeling that's gotten me down. Aita for buying a house with a different real estate agent, instead of my sister. User comment, not the a-hole. And, your sister is not worth your time feeling bad if she thinks that you're a loser. You have a good job and you're financially responsible, enough so to even afford a house. That's far from being a loser. Video game playing doesn't hurt anyone or make someone a loser either. My husband would much rather stay home and play video games than go out. In fact, he's playing one now. The world takes all kinds of people to function. Be you and don't apologize for it. User comment, not the a-hole. Homes are not just for married couples with children. Everyone needs a place of their own for shelter and to recharge. The same goes for careers. There shouldn't be a priority or mandate for job advancement only going to married men with children. I'm glad you got a different realtor. You have worked hard and you deserve a safe place to live. You are a valued member of society and you contribute in your own way. You are irreplaceable. Suggest you don't spend any time with your toxic sister. She does not enrich your life and detracts you from your goals. Good luck to you and your new home. User comment, not the a-hole. I'm a realtor. Working with family can be dicey. It sounds like your sister is incapable of being professional. You don't deserve to have the professional that you are paying, through the price of the home, to be so condescending to you. Your lifestyle is not up for judgment by your realtor, and if your sister is not behaving professionally, she deserves to lose the commission. As a side note, you sound like a great success to me. Just because you have no interest in having a relationship and a traditional family doesn't mean you're not a great and worthwhile person. It sounds like you are very happy and doing well. If you were my kid, I'd be very proud of you and your accomplishments. Have you told your parents how she was treating you? I would think they'd see your perspective. Next one posted by user, Throwaway Sell House. Titled, Aita for not letting a family buy our home. My husband and I are selling our house, and we were touring a woman and her husband who are getting ready to start a family. They offered a full cash offer, and it was right at what we were selling the house for. However, they were talking about making so many renovations. For example, the wife looked in the kitchen and said, "I wish there was an island in here, but we can figure that out. There are two smaller bedrooms in the home right next to each other," and she talked about knocking the wall down to make one big room. The whole time I just felt upset because this was the home my parents built and my kids grew up in, and I made sure to never make significant changes because I did not want to destroy their hard work. When they were leaving, I said we'll keep in touch. I called the couple later that night and told them we'll be moving on to a different buyer. I told my husband that I'm not interested in them purchasing our home. He thought I was joking until I explained my reasoning. He said I was too attached to this house, and that if I was going to have so many specifications on the buyer, then he's going to choose himself. He called the couple back today and they said they found a new house but to thank the both of us. He was livid. He started going off about how it's taken so long for us to find someone to actually pay the full price, especially with a full cash offer, but now we're either going to have to settle or wait forever to get a buyer like that. I told him no amount of money is going to make me okay with the destruction of my childhood home. Now he's angry, and won't talk to me, unless he absolutely has to. Aita? User comment: "You're the a-hole, that was a really stupid thing to do, especially without consulting your husband first. Just because you sell the house doesn't mean you lose the memories in it. Also, once it's sold you will never be going back, so you won't ever see what they do. Whoever buys it will likely still renovate, so turning down a full cash offer at asking is incredibly dumb." User comment: "Once you sell a thing, the thing is not your thing. You get no say in what happens to the thing. If Op thinks any buyer isn't going to change the house, she's delusional, and her husband is definitely right, she's way too attached. You're the a-hole." User comment: "You're the a-hole, and that is why you have an agent who takes care of this. When we sold our houses, we were never there when someone toured, partly for this exact reason. And if this is a really old house that's never been renovated, everyone's going to make changes, probably significant. Just because they don't say it doesn't mean they aren't making plans as they walk through. Only an idiot turns down a full price cash offer. And it sounds like it's been on the market for a while, so good luck now." Next one posted by user, Anna M569. Titled, "Aita for not wanting former owner of house to come visit? My fiancé and I bought our first house in January. When we did the inspection the owner was there, she cried a bit and mentioned how long she had been in the house, 47 years, and wasn't sure she was ready to sell. The inspection went well, and we purchased the house. We did the final walkthrough on the only day we were available, which was 3 days before closing. The former owner was moving that day, she cried again while we did the walkthrough. My husband and I felt bad and mentioned that she could come visit when she was in town as she was moving 8 hours away to be with her daughter. We didn't think it would be often. As we did the walkthrough she mentioned there were some things in the yard she wanted to keep but were buried under 4 feet of snow, including a tombstone, so we thought she would come in the spring to get her stuff and that would be it. Less than 2 weeks later she called my fiancé, we did not give her any phone numbers, to see if we found anything in the house that was hers. We hadn't. A few weeks after that she adds my fiancé on FB and messages him. I'm in town, and have driven by a few times and I think I'm ready for a visit, when is good for you? So my fiancé lets her come do a walk through, because we felt bad. She was upset we painted. She has now started messaging fiancé about the birds at the house and different springtime things. I told my fiancé that when she comes to get the tombstone and yard stuff I don't really want her in the house. We both feel like a holes because we said she could come visit but we really didn't think it would be so often. Would I be the a-hole if we told her no to a house tour when she comes to get her yard items? Edit: yes, it has only been one visit, and one planned visit. But we have only had the house since mid-January. We had barely moved in, just painted one room, when she wanted to come back. It was definitely sooner than we had ever imagined. For those wondering, we changed the locks immediately. It's one of those fancy ones off Amazon that are digital and pick-resistant. We do not have a spare key outside just in case. We also installed a security camera that catches the door, driveway, shed and gazebo. Also, at some points it felt like she didn't want to sell, but she also buried a statue of Saint Joseph in the front yard that she wants to come back for. When I looked it up, I found out that you do this to speed up the sale of your home. User comment, not the a-hole. I would block her on social media, but keep her number though. I know it's hard for less of people to realize, but you can actually just have a stab at letting people know what you actually need and think. It's a good way to practice setting boundaries. What op needs to do is call this woman on the phone and let her know that you're happy to let her visit, but that the visits will only happen once a year. Op can let her know that she understands there's a lot of memories attached to this home, and it was probably a very hard decision to sell it, but it is not her house anymore. That it feels a little difficult to keep allowing her in when they want to make their own new memories in the home. User comment, no a-holes here. Ultimately, she's clearly having difficulty moving on from this house. I wouldn't say that makes her an a-hole. Equally, she can't expect to come and go from that house as she pleases as it is no longer her house and should respect that. You sound like you've been more than kind enough so far, you aren't an a-hole for saying no to a house tour when she comes to pick up her things. Just because she's having difficulty moving on, doesn't mean that's your problem. User comment, no a-holes here. Maybe you should make it clear how you've stamped your ownership, so she can see how it isn't her house any longer. And then suggest that it would be better for both of you if she didn't visit as often, as she obviously finds the changes distressing. Next one posted by user, Thisleman. Titled, Aita for not letting a carjacked guy in my house. I was home at around 12:30 at night when there was a knock on my door. I was in bed and figured whoever it was had the wrong house. Sometimes we get food deliveries for the number opposite ours, so would realize that and move on. The knocking kept on for another 30 seconds or so and I started worrying it was my mum who was staying with me and she'd gone out for a smoke and gotten locked out. An average looking guy was standing there knocking on my door but looking out at the street. I said basically, can I help you, and he said he'd been carjacked and his phone was in the car and he needed to come in and call someone to get him. I took a second to think about this and basically thought to myself, I've got my kid and my elderly mum in here. If this were to somehow go bad, am I confident I could handle it by myself? The answer was no. So I said through the door, basically, listen, it's late and I don't know you, but I'll tell you what, I'll call 911 for you and you can wait out there. The guy said basically, I don't know if they're still around there, man, you have to let me in. I saw his face, what if he comes back, and I said, sorry, I can't do that. I call 911 to help you or I can call 911 to have you leave my porch, so he said, you're really not going to let me in? And I said basically, it's late and I can call 911 or you can go, but no, you can't come in, I don't know you. And he left. My mum was up and was coming over just after this exchange and said, who are you talking to? The baby is asleep, who's here? And I explained the situation and she said basically, the guy was carjacked and you didn't let him in? That's wrong. You help a person in need even if it's inconvenient, and I was like, you know, I didn't know him and I've got you and the kid in here. And she said basically, you've got to give people the benefit of the doubt. That's what's wrong with society today, is we won't open our doors for our neighbors. So obviously now, having heard that, I feel like a total dick. And I'm just sitting up thinking about it. Was I in a hole? User comment, not the a-hole. If somebody was really carjacked, they'd be freaking the duck out and screaming for you to call 911. Your spidey senses tingled that something wasn't right about his demeanor. It sounds more like a drug deal gone wrong, so he didn't want police involved, or worse, he was trying to do you harm. User comment, a hole. You need to have a talk with your mum. She could have put your family's lives at risk if she was the one that answered the door and let the guy in. User comment, not the a-hole. Sure, you can give people the benefit of the doubt, but at 12:30 at night in a neighborhood where this guy just got carjacked? Yeah, there is being neighborly and then there is being just plain stupid. Opening the door in the middle of the night to strangers can fall into the latter category, and when it does, the blame would go right back to you. Why did she let him in? She should know better. You did the exact right thing by offering to call 911. You didn't turn him away. You just didn't let him in. His refusal of the help you offered while insisting he let you in is suspicious. Next one posted by user, Bad Robot. Titled, Aita for refusing to let a strange older woman into my house at night. I was at home by myself, and around 7:50 p.m, someone rang the doorbell. I checked the video feed and saw it was an older woman, maybe 70, that I didn't recognize, standing outside with a bag. When I opened the door, she said, oh, they left me outside, so can I come in? When she asked to come in, she started to physically maneuver past me to walk into the house without waiting for my response. So I blocked the door, and I asked her again why she wanted to come in. She said again that they left her outside. I looked, and there was a pickup truck idling in the street and the passenger door fully ajar. Someone was in the driver's seat, and it looked like he was waiting for her. I told her, I'm sorry, but I can't let you into my house, I don't know you. She said, well, I can't wait outside. And I offered to call the police for her if she needed, and she said that was fine. I closed the door, and she got into the truck, which then drove forward so they were in front of the house next door. It was all very creepy, and I was home alone, so I called the police to tell them the situation. My fiancé knew I was a little nervous about it, especially because I had just recently moved into the house, so he came home and checked the video feed. It turns out that the woman is our next door neighbor, who he assumed got locked out of her house. I've met her once or twice before, but I hadn't recognized her, and she never mentioned that she is our neighbor or tried to clarify the situation other than that she was left outside. My fiancé thinks that she might be in the early stages of dementia but says that it was an honest mistake on my part. Still, I feel like a major a-hole. So, Aita? Edit, I brought her flowers to apologize. She had the flu, so she didn't come out to talk to me. I spoke with her husband, and he was very understanding and accepted the apology. He said that that night there was an unusual situation at his work, not sure why she was there, so one of his co-workers drove her home in a pickup truck, and he was to be home about 15 minutes after her arrival. She got home and realized that she didn't have a key, so she figured she could pop over to my house while she waited. All understandable from their perspective, but does not explain her strange behavior or lack of clarifying information. He didn't give any information about her mental state, and I didn't feel it appropriate to pry. I did get both of their full names, his cell phone number, and his home phone number. I gave him mine as well as my fiancé's. All lines of communication are now open between our two homes, and I hope that moving forward, they know they can come to us for any help they need. Thanks to everyone who commented. Like many of you helped me realize, it is easy to feel bad now that I have all the information, but in the moment, I made the safest decision for myself. Better safe than sorry, always. User comment, not the a-hole. The neighbors should let you know if she's prone to wandering, or whoever was driving her around should have come to the door with her. In the future, though, you may want to just talk through the door rather than opening it for strangers. User comment, not the a-hole. A lot of robberies go down this way, where the robber will use an elderly person or a child as a decoy, cause they know it will normally pull on people's heartstrings. You invite the person in your house because you feel sorry for them or whatever reason, and next thing you know you're tied up and your house is being robbed, if not worse. You can't be too safe these days, especially if you're new in an area and you're not familiar with people there yet. You absolutely did the right thing. User comment, not the a-hole. You didn't know what was going on or who she was or if she was in danger, so you were right to call the police with her outside. Though I would have waited with her outside. Last one posted by user, sarp_nina. Titled, Aita for not letting my dad drive my brand new car around the corner to the store. Okay, so a few months ago, I finally got my first car. A brand new car, might I add. Never in a million years did I think I could afford something like this at 20 years old. Well, I'm very protective of my car. My parents pay the insurance on it, which I will forever be grateful for, but it's only an extra maybe $30 a month while my payments are $243 a month. To get to the main part of this story, today I was sitting doing some at home school work, duck COVID, and my dad and my brother are outside putting up Christmas lights. They realized they needed more hooks for the lights, so my dad needs to drive to the store around the corner. Keep in mind, we have a car here he can drive. The car here is a 2006 Ford. So not the nicest. My dad is a very materialistic man and doesn't want to drive the Ford around. He won't say it, but I know it's because he doesn't want to look poor. The car isn't in great shape exterior wise. So basically, he has a car that is his, my mum's, he can drive, and got mad when I said no to him taking my car. This is the man, by the way, who crashed into a parked vehicle right around the corner from our house because he was on Facebook while driving. So excuse me if I don't trust him in my brand new car I worked so hard to get, even to drive it around the corner. Not only that, but his driving is horrendous. I could go into detail, but it would make this post that much longer. Now my brother is calling me ungrateful because they used to let me drive their cars around when I didn't have one. How else was I supposed to get to and from work or the store if they didn't feel like driving me? So, Aita? Edit, I feel like I might be because yeah, I did drive their cars around a lot before I had my own, but it was the only way I could get to where I needed if they didn't want to drive me. User comment, not the a-hole. Brother's argument is false equivalency, because as you said, you had no other car to use, and you hadn't established a proven inability to drive around the corner safely like your father has. User comment, everyone sucks here. Start paying your own insurance if you really don't want them to look at your car as theirs. User comment, not the a-hole. If he's not driving a car because he's materialistic, that's on him. He had another option, so you aren't to blame. Thanks for listening.